Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What another beautiful and awesome day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day right now to give him all the thanks right now, to give him all the praise right now, and to give him all the glory. We serve an awesome God. We serve a mighty God. We serve an amazing God. We serve a God who still sits on the throne, and he still performs miracles and wonders each and every day in the mighty name of Jesus. He is still in the healing business, and he is still in the blessing business. God is good all the time, and all the time God is good, and he is so worthy, hallelujah. I say he is so worthy to be praised. I tell you, my brothers and sisters, God is so awesome. He's so amazing. He is so faithful. Every day is a day to enter to his courts with thanksgiving and praise. This worshiping his name, glorify his name, magnify his name right now today. Because he is your everything. You can't do it without Jesus. You can't make it without Jesus. And if you have not welcomed Jesus into your life today, to your home today, what are you waiting on right now? And if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus, I encourage you to have one right now today. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, we just come before you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me all thanks. Give me all praise. Give me all glory. We just thank you, Father God, for who you are, what you've done, and what you're about to do. We thank you, Father God, how you're moving in this place right now. We thank you, Father God, how you're touching us right now. We thank you, Father God, how you're ordering our steps, Father God. Oh, Father God, we thank you today, Father God, because we know that you're in control and you're in charge of every last situation that we are going through right now. Oh, Father God, you are awesome to us. You are mighty to us, God. You are powerful to us, God. Oh, Father God, today is the day that you have made. We're so glad to be a part of and rejoice in it. Heavenly Father God, we thank you for this word that we're about to receive. We thank you, Father God, for this powerful message today. It's going to keep us full today, keep us satisfied today. There's no place that we'd rather be at right now today, Jesus, but right here in your house, right here in your sanctuary, Father God, just lift me up with thanksgiving and praise, Father God. Oh, Father God, let your will be done today, Father God. Let your words go out, and it should not return by void today, Father God. Oh, Father God, I believe and I declare a decree today, God, that someone's going to be healed today. Someone's going to be delivered today. Someone is ready to give their life over to you right now today, Jesus. Someone is tired of living in darkness, Father God. And Father God, you're going to get all the thanks for it. You're going to get all the praise for it. And you're going to get all the glory, Father God. Oh, Father God, we worship you today, Father God. We magnify your name right now today, Father God. We exalt your holy name right now today, Father God. Oh, Father God, allow your presence to move to this place. Allow your love to move to this place. Allow your angels to join us in praise and worship today, Father God, in your place today, Father God. Heavenly Father God, Abba Father, you are welcome right now. You are invited right now today to enter to your home right now, right here in your prayer, right here in your sanctuary right now, right here in your YouTube channel, your platform, right here in my brother's homes and my brother's life, right here in my sister's homes and my sister's life. Father God, I'm asking right now today to quiet our thoughts right now, soften our heart right now today, Father God. Father God, I'm asking Father God to do a new thing in my brother's life right now, a new thing in my sister's life right now. Father God, I'm asking Father God for favor right now. Father God, you know exactly what we are going through. Father God, you know exactly what we are facing right now. And Father God, we just ask you, Father God, to touch us right now. To speak a word to us right now today, Father God. Oh, Father God, give us peace of mind right now today, Father God. Oh, Father God, we don't know what's happening, Father God, but we are trusting you. Father God, we don't understand what has took place, but we are trusting you. Father God, we're going to trust you through the good times. We're going to trust you through the bad times. We're going to trust you through the ugly times. We're going to trust you while we're in the storm. We're going to trust you, Father God, when we're going through these difficulties. We are going to trust you. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you are welcome right now. You're invited right now today to enter to the house of the Lord right now. Right in this sanctuary right now. Right here on Jesus' YouTube channel's platform right now. Right here in my sister's homes and my sister's life. Right here in my brother's homes and my brother's life. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to intercede and intervene right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to quiet our thoughts, quiet our mind right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you right now today to let us catch the Holy Ghost fire right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to reveal every anything to us. If anyone is trying to do some harm to us, they got anything that's hidden in the dark, it's something that we need to be aware of. Holy Spirit, please alert us right now. Holy Spirit, please let us know right now today. Father God, words cannot explain how thankful, how grateful, how honored and blessed I am to pray, praise and have fellowship today with all my brothers, all my sisters today, Father God, and one body Christ today. Father God, we're here today to let you know that we're available for praise, that we're available for service, that we're available for kingdom, but most of all, Jesus, that we're available for you, Father God. Heavenly Father God, please forgive us for our sin today, Father God, known and unknown right now. Wash us through your blood right now. Clean us right now as white as snow right now. Father God, I want to say thank you right now today for forgiveness for our sin. Thank you, Father God, for not remembering our sins anymore. Thank you, Father God, for the clean slate. Thank you, Father God, for the understanding. Thank you, Father God, for coming through, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Before I get started, it's something that's always in my mind about you. It's something that stays in my spirit about you. It's something that stays on the fruit of my tongue and the fruit of my lips about you. And I just got to tell you how I really feel about you, Jesus. I just can't thank you enough, 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 Jesus. I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I glorify you the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I magnify and shout out your holy name the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I pour my heart out to you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why you're always first place in my life, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I brag, that's why I boast about you. That's why I talk about you all day long, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just 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 can't thank you enough. Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. And if you're ready for God's word, let the church say amen. But let Jesus know right now today. Let Jesus know right now today that you can't thank him. That you can't thank him enough. Somebody has gotten themselves in a situation. Somebody has gotten themselves into a dilemma right now. And right now, the enemy is thinking they won. Friends thinking that they won. Family members thinking that they won. In-laws thinking that they won. But Jesus wants y'all to be quiet right now. Because Jesus is going to get some glory out of this situation, my sisters. Jesus is going to get some glory out of this situation right now today, my brothers. There's been a lot of he say and she say going on lately. There's been a lot of pointing fingers at one another lately. It's been blaming one another lately. And friends just sitting back just looking at it. Family members just sitting back looking at it. In-laws just sitting back looking at it. The enemy sitting back clapping his hand just looking at it, say, wow, we don't broke up a soon-to-be marriage. We don't broke up a marriage. We don't broke up a friendship. We don't steal, kill, and destroy somebody's whole livelihood right now. And right now you're looking back at it and say, when the world took place, what happened between us? Everything was all good. Now look at us now. We don't even talk no more. We mad at each other right now. Some of us right now, you hate each other for no reason. Because you allow too many people all in your business. You allow too many people to know what was going on between yourself. If they weren't doing that, but destroying what God has put together. And right now, you know what they're saying? Our job is done. Ain't going to be no marriage for them. Ain't going to be no friendship with them. Oh, their marriage done now. It's doomed now. That's what they sit back doing. That's what they sit back was talking about. They were too busy worried about y'all two and what y'all had going on because their situation was messy. They was too signified what was going on with y'all because their situation was messy. They had too much time on their hand worried about y'all because their situation, oh, help me this thing, Jesus, was messy. Messy people always stick their nose in other people's business. Messy people always causing confusion. Messy people always causing a problem. That's what messy people do. And right now, They know your situation is in a mess right now. They don't care nothing about it because they ain't trying to fix it. They ain't trying to reconcile y'all two back together or none of that. In their mind, they feel like the job is done. But I'm going to tell you about the God I serve. I'm going to tell you about the God that I praise. He always got the last say-so. He always had the last final word. And right now, God is telling me to tell somebody right now today, it's time to be quiet right now. You have done too much talking because you was a part of it too. He wants you to be quiet right now. He wants you to be silent right now. He don't want you to say a word. He wants you to sit back and allow Jesus to do what he do best. Leave everything in his hand and let him take care of what you can't take care of. See, that same mess that you got yourself into is going to be that same mess that Jesus is going to clean up, and he's going to make it right. Because I'm going to tell you right now today, my sisters, I'm going to tell you right now today, my brothers, God is going to get some glory out of this situation which y'all in right now. It might look like it's ugly right now. It look like it's funky right now. It look like it ain't going nowhere right now. It look like that it's over with right now. But Jesus said, I am the one, the Alpha and the Omega. I have the last say so. He's about to show up and he's about to show out right now. Somebody right now is in a state of an emergency right now because of the situation that you are in. And you don't like it. You don't feel good because you want to pick up the phone and you want to reach out. But the Lord said, not right now. Not right now. Let me go in and do what I got to do because the enemy, family members, in-laws, friends has caused some damage between some people right now. They caused a lot of chaos between some people right now today. I don't know about you today, my sisters. I don't know about you today, my brother. Somebody is in a situation right now. And the situation right now ain't looking too good. Everybody's all upset at the wrong people. They ain't looking at the people who's causing the mess. They ain't looking at the people who's causing the drama. They ain't looking at them. But they the ones who sit back laughing at the whole situation. That's what they doing. That's why you're in a state of an emergency right now. Because it's messed up right now. God said, I didn't bring y'all this far for y'all to fall out. I didn't bring y'all this far for y'all to start disliking each other, for y'all to stop hating each other, for y'all to stop loving each other. God said, I didn't brought y'all this far. God said, I brought y'all together for a reason. I brought y'all together for a purpose. But both y'all was dead wrong. Both y'all allowed certain people all in your business. And they were stirring to stuff was not even true. Making up allegations wasn't even right. He said this, she said that. Playing both sides of the fence. That's what they was doing. And right now, it's a hot mess right now. Because this person right here saying that, this person saying that, this person right here said, oh, that's what they really said about you. This person right here calling other people on the phone and said, okay, you want to listen to what they're talking about? See, that's causing the confusion. It's causing a mess. That's all what that is. And right now, Jesus got to silence the crowd because too many people, it's all in your business. Too many people in your business, my sisters. Too many people in your business, my brother. And God got to do something about that. And he's going to do something about it because he's going to get some glory out of this situation. Even though your friends think they don't want. Even though your family members think they don't want. Even though your in-laws thinking that they have won. The enemy himself think they is won. But how can they win when God gonna get the glory out of it? God gonna get the glory out of it, and he gonna get the victory out of it. And he gonna put y'all right back together. He gonna open your eyes. He gonna let y'all see what both of y'all did wrong. Because right now, both of y'all are in the state of an emergency right now. Both of y'all need each other right now. Both of y'all allowed the enemy to come to steal, kill, and destroy what God has brought together. Come on, somebody. Somebody know what I'm talking about. Somebody in a situation right now today. You don't know how you got yourself in there, but watch how God gets you out. Some of y'all in a situation right now today, you saying, wow, now I don't hear from nobody no more now. I don't hear from family members no more. I don't hear from in-laws no more. I don't hear from friends no more. Because why? They think that they think everything is over with. That's why you don't hear from them no more. You don't hear from your kids no more. Everybody don't scatter like roaches right now. Because they thinking that they have won. They think that the battle is over. They might have won the battle. But they ain't won the war. That's why Jesus is going to get some glory out of the situation. He's the one. Jesus is going to get some victory out of this situation right here today. I promise you he is. It ain't over like the enemy think that it's over. Watch how God come to you. Watch how he fixed the whole situation. Watch how he turned the whole thing around for you, my brothers and sisters. You better get ready because he's about to do some things. Right now, the only thing that Jesus needs you to do is be quiet. He don't want you to open your mouth. He don't want you to say a word. He just wants you to be quiet. That's why he's going to test you that, just to see, are you really going to be quiet? He's going to test you just to see, do you really believe in him, trust in him enough that he's going to turn this situation around for you? He's going to test you just to see, do you really know that he's going to get the glory and the victory out of the situation? Even though that you understand it, even though that you're in a state of an emergency, even though you're in a situation, he's going to test you to see how you're going to work it out. It's time to be quiet, my sisters. It's time to be quiet, my brothers. You ain't got to say nothing. You ain't got to open your mouth. I know it's making you feel a certain way. I know it's making you feel a certain way today because you want to reach out. You miss that certain person. But guess what? That certain person miss you too. Don't think that person miss you because right now you're feeling that person's emotion and that person is feeling your emotion. Both of y'all are feeling each other's emotions right now because both of y'all are in the situation right now. You blaming him, he blaming her. And it's both of y'all fault. Y'all's now the wrong people in your business. You talk too much like she talked too much. Both of y'all said something. Don't start pointing the fingers. Oh, you said this, oh, he said it. No, both of y'all said it. The same way that you got yourself in that situation, it's going to be the same way how God's going to get you out of that situation, and he's going to clean it up. Amen? Amen. So can you please turn your Bible to Matthew 20, and we're going to read verse 31. That's Matthew 20, and we're going to read verse 31. And if you have the Bible open, please say amen. The crowd rebuked them and told them to be quiet. But they shouted all the louder, Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us. Jesus stopped and called them. What do you want me to do for you? He asked. Lord, they answered, we want our sight. Jesus had compassion on them and touched their eyes immediately. They received their sight and followed him. Jesus is going to touch your eyes. He's going to allow you to see who was against y'all the whole time. Jesus is going to touch somebody's eyes. He's going to allow you to see who was against your marriage, your relationship, your job, your friendship, who was hating on you, who didn't want y'all to be happy, who didn't want their marriage to go down, who didn't want their marriage to work. He's going to let y'all to see who didn't want y'all to have their job. He's going to allow y'all to see it. He's going to remove the fish scales from your eyes so you can see exactly who they are. He's going to allow you to see who was the messy ones and who really was. He's going to allow you to see that you was mad at the wrong person, but the people who you need to be mad at was right there in front of your face. He's going to allow you to see it. He's going to allow you to see it. But you got to silence the crowd. And right now, he just wants you to be quiet right now. You got to let Jesus do what he do. Because he don't need your help, my sisters. He don't need your help, my brothers. The same situation that you got yourself in is going to be the same situation that God's going to get you out of it. And right now, we are in a state of emergency right now. Because you don't want to let that loved one go. You don't want to let that friendship go. You don't want to let that marriage go. You really don't want to let your fiance go. You really don't want to let that job go. You really don't want to let that career go. Watch out, God, work it out for you. Watch out, God, work it out for you. And he's going to allow you to see who was the busybodies, who were the messy people, who's the one who's causing all that chaos. See, they start trouble with you, but they also talk behind your back about you too. Trust and believe. The moment you turn your back, they talking about y'all. They talking about everything that y'all going through. But you study smiling their face. You study think, oh, they ain't gonna do me like that. You study think, oh, that's my friend. Oh, them my aunties, them my uncles. Well, their so-called friend, their uncle, their auntie, they talking about you. They are the missing one. And God's gonna open your eyes. He's gonna allow you to see. That's why God's gonna get the glory out of it. That's why God's gonna get the victory out of it. I promise you what he told me today. He said, be quiet. The point I'm making, be quiet. And watch how he silenced the crowd. Right now, we have a crowd that's in your finances right now. Right now, you have a crowd that's talking about your health right now. You have a crowd that's talking about your marriage right now. You have a crowd that's talking about your fiance right now. You have a crowd that's talking about jibber jabber. And Jesus got to silence the crowd. He got to move everybody away. That's what he's going to do right now today in this season. That's what he's about to do right now today. He's going to get somebody attention right now. He's about to silence the crowd. Move all the wicked people out of the way. Move all the people that's busybody out of the way. Move all the messy people that's out of the way. And he's going to touch your eyes, my sisters. And he's going to touch your eyes, my brothers. And he's going to allow you to see who they really were the whole time. Jesus is that good. Jesus is that awesome. Jesus is that amazing. Jesus is that faithful. Watch what he do for you, my sisters and brothers. Get ready. Just keep quiet. And if you know God is talking to you, you know this word is concerning you, go and hit this like button. Hit the subscribe button too as well. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life, to guide us, direct us, use us. I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, I was praying a simple little prayer that God is already working everything out in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is withers.lt. Always keep Jesus first place. Always seek him, always honor him, always praise him. Always keep your eyes focused on Jesus, because he is the author and the perfecter of your faith. Continue to trust him even though you don't see anything happening. Continue to hold on to his unchangeable hands, and please do not let it go. Continue to pick up your crosses and follow Jesus. Choose faith over fear. Always continue to pray for your fellow brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if you know them. It doesn't matter if you're the same in their face. Prayer helps and prayer changes things. I'm always going to continue to keep y'all in prayer, my brothers and sisters. The only thing that I ask y'all guys to do for me is continue to keep me in prayer and keep me lifted up too. I'm 7 minutes LT. I love y'all. Stay blessed. In Jesus' name we pray. Glory, hallelujah. Amen.